Hello everybody, welcome to another video. I wanted to do something different than just a review. I recently bought the Epiphone Brand Heinz Flying V, this super nice guitar here. Review will follow. I already made an unboxing, but the review will come for sure, okay? And yeah, I looked into more Epiphones, into more Flying Vs and Explorer shapes. We will look today into two Epiphones, the Corina Flying V and the Amos, the Joe Bonamassa Amos Flying V. I stumbled online upon some people that were wondering why they should pay so much more for the Amos, because they both look almost like the same guitars, okay? And yeah, we will look into this together. I hope it's a little bit entertaining or something. Let's do it. Okay. We are here on the Thomann page for the Epiphone LTD ED Corina Flying V, the standard Epiphone Flying V Corina for €495. No case. On the other tab, we got the Joe Bonamassa 1958 Amos for €825. And this guitar comes with the case. But more later. Okay, so on first sight, almost same guitars, right? Yeah, on first sight it is like this. So let's zoom in here on the standard Corina. And I can tell you, it looks like a two-piece body, right? Yeah, looks like it, but it's not. This is a veneer, okay? We got here veneer on top. And also veneers on the back, or let's say two veneers on the front and two veneers on the back. Okay, it looks like a glue line here in the middle. And this is a veneer and this is a veneer. So they make it look like it's a two-piece body. Yeah, it really looks on first sight like a two-piece body, but it's not. These are veneers, like I already said, and we can see the glue joints on this photo here. Okay, they made it really clever, I have to say. So if the player looks down on this guitar, this looks, here are no glue joints on this side. On the side facing the player is no glue joint, very clever. But here we can see one piece, there's a glue joint, two piece, there's a glue joint, and yeah, at least it's a three-piece body at least, with veneers on top and back. So that's of course something to talk about, okay? That's one thing why the price is lower, because on the Joe Bonamassa, let's look here quickly, okay? We got really a two-piece body here. This is really a two-piece body. There's a glue joint in the middle, but of two full pieces of wood, okay? Really Corina here, there are no other glue joints, just here in the middle, left, right. So that's of course a big difference for some people, for people that believe in tone wood and stuff. Of course, that's a difference. I cannot see any signs of a veneer or something. This is really a massive two-piece body. Okay, back to the standard Corina Flying V. Of course, still a nice looking guitar. Yeah, we got the standard Epiphone logo here. Let me see here. Standard Epiphone logo, and yeah, nothing wrong with it. On the Bonamassa, on the other hand, we got this, how do you call it? Is this engraved? No. But we got this full fat Epiphone logo here, and the Amos truss rod cover, which looks really nice. But there's more to this, okay, to this guitar. This is really a copy of Joe Bonamassa's Flying V, of the Amos Flying V, of his favorite Gibson Flying V he got. And so we can expect probably a nicer neck profile, and overall we got probably a better quality guitar. And this guitar comes with a case. We got the full case here with Amos in Indianapolis, Indiana, Epiphone, and the Joe Bonamassa logo. Now, if you look into a case, just a case, okay, the standard Epiphone Flying V case is already €105. If you add this to the standard price here, to the €495, you are around €600 already. And the Amos is €825, so there's a difference of €225 still. Of course, Bonamassa wants to earn some money too. And if the overall quality of the guitar is better, the 200 euro extra are worth it, in my opinion, okay? There is, of course, more to this guitar, more details, okay? They used really black screws here on the pickguard. On the standard LTD Carina, they use gold, but these are little details. And yeah, the Amos got also got, do we got here, picture. We got here the white input jack cover, okay, on the Amos. That's just the way Bonamassa's Flying V looks like, and they modeled it after this. So I can tell you I'm really interested in the Amos, and I would save my money to get the Amos over the standard Flying V. The standard Flying V is a great guitar. I played it once, and it's a good guitar, don't get me wrong, okay? Just wanted to point out the differences. And there are probably more differences I can see right now here. But I guess the neck shape is nicer, and maybe the fret ends are made differently. So that's how the fret ends of the Amos looks like. A little bit rounded, looks good. They use, by the way, black wood on this guitar. They don't use rosewood anymore. The Thomann page still says rosewood on the standard Carina Flying V. I'm not sure if this is right, to be honest with you. So this is the closest I can get here to the fret ends of the standard Flying V. Does not look wrong. To be honest, it looks right now as if the guitar got binding. I'm sure it don't got binding, but it just looks like. Both guitars got no fretboard binding. Yeah. I cannot say anything to the pickups. I hope I can get the Amos, to be honest. I want to have it, to own it. The Epiphone Pro Buckers in the neck and the Pro Bucker 3, the Pro Bucker 2 in the neck, the Pro Bucker 3 in the bridge, and the standard Carina Flying V got the Olnico Classics. I don't know if the Amos pickups are better. I guess they are, but I can't say for sure. I don't want to repeat myself too much. I guess, and here's the man himself. Okay, Joe Bonamassa. And yeah, I guess the overall feel of the guitar will be different on the Amos. I would love to test both of them here. But yeah, that's it. This is the first time I do something like this. I hope you like it. If you got some suggestions which guitars I should look at together with you or compare, and if you know more about the two guitars or about just the Amos, let me know. Write it in the comments below. Really, I want to hear it because I'm really interested in this guitar, for sure. And yeah, that's it. By the way, the guitar comes, of course, with the certificate and manual and poster and stickers. And yeah, overall, I think the price is good just from what I can see here right now. Really want to have this guitar to test it, and I think it will be awesome. I think it will be awesome. Okay, thanks for watching. Have a nice day.